my research here as a group leader at the NIN is about compulsive behavior and about how our behavior is either in control or out of our control.
The way we approach how the brain controls behavior in general and how the brain loses control is by observing rodents, mice and rats, and studying them and their behavior, and at the same time really looking into what happens in their brain on a very high time resolution, second by second, and then relate the brain activity with the behavior itself. So let's say, for example, the rats learn how to press a lever that's present in their environment to receive a reward. What we would look at, for example, is how this behavior is initially quite goal-directed and very specific, and then if they do it many, many, many times, it becomes habitual, so it sort of is out of their conscious control. It's just something that happens automatically. And we want to see that switch in the brain that really flips when the behavior becomes more automatic and outside of conscious control. Because we believe that that may have something to do with what we see in patients that have compulsive disorders.
I think it's important to understand these topics and ask these questions because, well, first of all, it's really a frontier in human knowledge. It's like understanding the universe. We would like to understand what our brain does because it also tells us something about ourselves in a way. So it has an element of introspection, I think. On the other hand, I think it's really important to understand how behavior becomes more automatic and compulsive to help patients in the clinics. So the first step would be to really understand what that mechanism is in the brain, and then based on that knowledge to come up with, you know, ideas for treating patients better, for example, drug addicts or OCD patients. It's going to be a long-term project, but I do think we can really design better treatments in the long term. Thank you.